Hello friends, let us now learn about some MCQs in stomach and duodenum. First, MCQ number 1. Most common site of carcinoma stomach is? Most common site of carcinoma stomach is gastric antrum. But in pernicious anemia, most common site of carcinoma stomach is fundus of the stomach. Then question number 2. Which carcinoma of stomach develops secondary to the pernicious anemia? It is usually situated in the secondary to pernicious anemia. It is usually seen at fundus of the stomach. See, normally the most common site of carcinoma stomach is gastric antrum, but carcinoma of stomach secondary to pernicious anemia is situated in the fundus of the stomach. Then question number 3. The best prognosis in carcinoma stomach is seen in among all these superficial spreading type has the best prognosis, whereas the linitis plastica has the worst prognosis among all these. Okay, the best prognosis in the carcinoma stomach is superficial spreading type, whereas the worst prognosis is linitis plastica. Then question number 4. All of the following indicates early gastric cancer except. First, involvement of mucosa. True, it is early gastric cancer. Involvement of mucosa and submucosa. Yes, involvement of mucosa, submucosa and muscularis. Look, once the gastric cancer has crossed submucosa and entered muscularis, then it is late gastric or advanced gastric carcinoma, not the early gastric cancer. Involvement of mucosa and submucosa with adjacent lymph nodes, true, that is early gastric carcinoma. Early gastric carcinoma is if there is involvement of mucosa and submucosa with or without lymph nodes is early gastric cancer. Early gastric cancer is classified by Japanese classification. Then, question number 5. For early diagnosis of carcinoma stomach, which method is used? For early diagnosis of carcinoma stomach, you should stain with endoscopic biopsy. You should do first, you should do an endoscopy, obtain a biopsy and then stain it with H&E staining and do microscopic examination for carcinoma of stomach. Then, question number 6. An adult presented with hematemesis and upper abdominal... An adult presented with hematemesis and upper abdominal pain. Endoscopy reveals a growth in the pyloric antrum of the stomach. CT scan showed growth involving the pyloric antrum without infiltration or invasion into the surrounding structures, and no evidence of distant metastasis is seen. At laparotomy, neoplastic growth was observed to involve the posterior wall of the stomach and pancreas extending 6 cm up to the tail of pancreas. What is the most appropriate surgical management? See, he has growth in the stomach and on CT scan you see in a pyloric antrum. Okay, it is neoplastic growth for sure. Okay, this neoplastic growth, this is important. This neoplastic growth is actually involving the posterior wall of the stomach and pancreas. That is extending up to 6 cm to the tail of pancreas. Okay, so now the tumor is in the posterior wall of the stomach and pancreas. It is in the distal part of the stomach because it has given that it is in the pyloric antrum. In the stomach, the tumor involves pyloric antrum. So, if the tumor is in the pyloric antrum, we can do subtotal gastrectomy. But if the tumor is present in the proximal part of the stomach or mid body, then you should do total gastrectomy. But in this question, the tumor is present in the pyloric antrum of the stomach. So you should do partial gastrectomy, number one. Second, it is also extending into the pancreas. So you should even remove the pancreas, right? And it is mainly extending into the tail of the pancreas. If it is extending up to the tail of pancreas, then you should do distal pancreatectomy. So C is the option. See, it is not D because it is not involving spleen. If the tumor is not involving spleen, then you need not do splenectomy. Right? Then, question number 6. Kali, 60-year-old male, diagnosed to have carcinoma of stomach. CT scan of abdomen showed a mass measuring 4 × 4 cm in the antrum with involvement of celiac nodes and right gastric nodes. Management of choice is, see here the patient has carcinoma of stomach and CT shows mass present in antrum. It is stomach cancer, antrum and involvement of celiac and right gastric nodes. So management of choice. First, you should resect the tumor, right? So you are going to do subtotal gastrectomy. You won't do total gastrectomy because the mass is involving the antrum, not the proximal part of the stomach. As the mass is involving the antrum, you will do subtotal gastrectomy. Okay? And you should do lymph node dissection also. But in the options given below, subtotal gastrectomy is sufficient. Next, question number 8. Operability in carcinoma of stomach is indicated by all except involvement of omental nodes. Once there is involvement of omental nodes, then we cannot operate it. Involvement of lymph nodes at celiac axis, yes, we can operate it. Lymph node at porta hepatis, we can operate it. Solitary metastatic nodule of in the liver can be resected. Krukenberg's tumor and involvement of omental nodes are not indicating the operability. You should not operate them in this stage. Last question of this lesson, of this lecture, is linitis plastica is commonly seen in, linitis plastica is commonly seen in carcinoma of stomach. It is seen in carcinoma of stomach. It is a type of diffuse carcinoma of stomach. Thank you guys for watching my lecture. Thank you.